there would be nothing.
You coming through the big speaker.
Without a woman or a girl.
We gonna have to hear the caller though.
I know, 1-2 check, 1-2. You know I'm coming through this main speaker, right?
You see?
1-2, 1-2.
Man made the cars to take us over the road.
1-2, 1-2. Okay, he got it. Okay.
Man made the train.
Nah, you good.
Nah, not good. To carry the head.
You know they can hear everything we say.
Not who that?
Right now.
Oh. Man made the electrolyte to take us out of the dark. Man made the boat for the water. Like Noah made the ark. This is a man's, man's, man's world. But it wouldn't be nothing, nothing. Without a woman or a girl.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Welcome to the man cave. Welcome, welcome, welcome. What you doing back there?
What DJ doing?
Welcome, welcome to the man cave where men are welcome. Women, enter at your own risk. Oh, yes. It's Wednesday, October the 9th. And I'm your host, DJ LJ.
DJ today.
Dang, man. I keep saying, man. I'm LJ. This is DJ. DJ Tony T. It's so many different DJs. I'm just tripping. Wednesday, October the 9th. Today's man code, as we always start off with,
yes,
is men, when you're shaking another man's hand, you got to give a firm shake.
I agree with that.
Can't shake another man's hand with a limp hand.
I agree with that.
That's just not cool. DJ, you
look
okay?
Look him in the eye, too.
Yeah.
Look
him in the eye. Yeah.
I don't like when people shake my hand and look down. What you looking down for? Yeah. Look me in my eye.
Shake a man's hand. Huh? Nice firm grip. All that limp hand stuff, I would tell you what that mean to me, but I don't want no active people to start, you know, getting mad at you,
exactly,
boy.
Exactly.
Tony T, why don't you tell them how to get a hold of us,
like
Skype and all that.
You got something on your mind, you want to get it off your chest, your head, whatever it is, 760-798-9848. That's the number to call in. Hit us up, let us know what's up. As well, you can stream it, your Androids, your phones, your computers. It's www.mydjs.com. www.mydjs.net.
And we can Skype, right?
And you can Skype in as well. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't know what Skype about.
I think it's the same. Just go on Skype and it's My DJ's Radio.
My DJ's Radio is a Skype ID. You can Skype yourself in.
No, actually, My DJ's for you.
My DJ's for you.
Well, thanks for telling us.
All right. My DJ's for you is the Skype address. Yeah. So
My DJ's Radio. My bad.
My DJ's Radio. We're going to get it right, y'all. We're going to get this, y'all. You know how it is.
It's
on
Monday.
I don't know.
Monday, Friday.
So, My DJ's Radio is the Skype address. If you want to Skype in, you got something you want to say, and if you want to hit us on the line, 760-798-9848. There we go. All right.
We at the shout-out section of the man cave.
Yes, we are.
We had to shout out. And first, I want to give a shout out to everyone who's been watching for the last couple of weeks. We're 2 months in. We're doing very well. And all the opinions that we have, all the suggestions and that. And with that being said, the opinions on this show is each individual opinion.
There you go.
The facts that's in there, some facts is based off of facts, but it's we have his opinion, DJ Tony T. We have DJ's opinion, and my opinion is like you listening to man talk. So
that's it.
This is shouts out to everybody, and I appreciate everything of what y'all say. But remember, these are our opinions, and you are listening to our opinions.
There
period.
It is.
Of each individual person.
If you don't like our opinion, write your congressman. Oh, you can.
The government shut down. That's right.
Yes. Oh, better yet, if you got your own opinion, hit us up.
That's right.
That's why we got a phone line.
That's right. That's right.
Get it off your chest.
We try our best to educate ourselves on every question and topic that we have, but if
our books didn't come in,
you know, the government shut down. Any shout outs for you, DJ?
Yeah, last week, give a shout out to Derek Memphis. He called in. He was gave us his jazz out of Compton, Chrissy San Diego.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah,
we had a couple of my parents from the football team, the Cardinals. Give a shout out to them. Matter of fact, give a shout out because they won last week as well. You know, my Cardinals won 4-0. My Ravens won. We're 4-0.
NFL play 60.
NFL play 60. We're doing it. We're doing it. We're doing like we're supposed to do. I do have a kind of a shout out, but I'll do it in a minute. Shout out to all the parents. I gotta find it. Okay. I have one. It's from my homegirl Latoya.
Mm-hmm.
She's doing this. They call body wraps. They tone tighten and firm for 45 minutes. What they do is detox your body shrinking.
Yeah.
Detox your body shrinking your fat cell.
Yeah.
You can get them for $59 if you sign up to be a loyal customer. Or you can call her to get more information at area code 901-604-3681. Or hit her up at ladymemphis.myitswork.com. That was a lot of information.
Well, that's what I was about to say. What her name is? Toya, next time, you need to pay that man. That's a lot of information. That's a lot of information.
About the rap, I'ma try it. So, you know, I'ma try
what
it.
What you need to rap?
I'll be honest with you.
It's nice.
You tried it?
It's nice people on television. I didn't say what I was going to say, but.
Yeah, they have them at the rapper bazaars. And it's a rap. They literally wrap you up. And what it does, it makes you sweat.
So I'm gonna go ahead and get that a try. You know, the summer coming in next year.
So do you get a free wrap for the shout out?
And your life is free.
You got any shout outs? Are you done?
No. Shout out to my happy birthday last week. My baby Lee, love you.
Lee. My bad, Lily.
That's it.
How about you, Tony?
Me, I'm just giving a shout out, like I say, to all the little listeners out there. Like LJ pointed out, we appreciate your comments and your concerns. Shout out to the Man Cave. Shout out to Green Light Radio. Shout out to My DJ's Radio. Just shout out to the whole world. Shout out to all the listeners.
Oh, wow. Okay, that's what's up.
Before we get into something, what's the next thing we got to do, Mr. LJ?
We're doing the call out next.
Call out. Before we get to the call out, can I get serious right quick?
Uh-huh.
Okay, we're in the month of October, and women, men as well, it's breast cancer awareness. The reason, hence the pink I got on, the pink being breast cancer, save the tatas. Women, check yourself. Breast cancer is real. It will kill you.
It kill men too.
Take your life. It will. I said, man. It will take your life. Trust me. Check. Examine yourself. Go get yourself checked. It will save your life. Let's do that.
Does it?
Yes.
That's it.
Wear the pink. Buy some pink. Small donation goes to breast cancer awareness.
I'm with him on that. Men as well.
Yeah.
It's uncomfortable what you got to do.
Yeah. We're going to the call out session. This is where I see something throughout the week and I just shake my head at it. I want to call out people who like statuses on Facebook that you're not supposed to like.
Oh, that gets on my nerve. My grandma's sick. Like, don't like that. There's nothing to like about.
What? No. You don't. That's not. There's not a dislike button or nothing on Facebook. Right. You just be like, oh, you know, do something else. You don't just like. You got to read the status.
Put it over there.
Like, read it.
And a lot of times they just look at the person that did it. So, you know, they may like them or they may have some, you know, association with them. It's like, oh, okay, my homegirl put this here. Like, never looked at.
And some people need to put something on there that's understandable. Like, you can't do an oxymoron while you on there, and I'm trying to figure out, do I like this status or not? Am I supposed to like this status?
A lot of my statuses,
they're confusing.
Make you think a little bit. You gotta use the left side of your brain.
You're lying. You're lying.
What?
Most of your status is you singing.
DJ, one man constant show. Look out now.
All he do is sing.
Yeah, that's true. I do get my sign. Y'all hear me sing? Here we go.
Oh, Lord. Look out.
Ask Factor. Three X Factor already. Let's go. No, we good.
This is not the voice.
We good. Quick topic.
That's it. This is not the voice.
We're about to get into the quick topic. Why don't you tell these people where they can answer this quick topic real fast?
Yes, call us in 760-798-9848. If you want to Skype in, My DJ's Radio. That's a Skype ID. You at mydjsradio.com and .net.
Man, I think they wanted to hear me sing.
They didn't want to hear me sing.
No. The first caller call in, say you want to hear me sing. Somebody call in right now and say you want to hear me sing.
Please don't sing.
Please don't. Oh.
So, the quick topic. If y'all listen to DJ quite often, you would hear him say, okay, that's what's up. If you would hear DJ say things like...
You mean me?
Yeah, you.
What do I say?
You're the only DJ.
This is quick topic. Now let me get the question.
Don't lie on me.
I ain't going to lie on you. Okay, here we go. On the quick topic, what I'm trying to say is you would hear DJ say stuff like, well, in the South, where I'm from in the South.
Really?
Yeah.
Really?
So, that brought me to this question right here.
There it is. Come on.
Good women that's in the South, is there a difference between a good woman that's raised in the South or a good woman that's raised in the East Coast or the Midwest or the West Coast?
Yes.
No.
Yes. I don't agree with that. Go ahead. Why you don't agree with it, Tony T?
Because a good woman is a good woman regardless of where she raised.
Go. It does make
God, no, it don't make no difference. The only difference it makes is in the rump size most of the time. Other than that, a good woman is a good woman. Regardless.
No, because I'm going to say it is a factor because if you look at it, you tend to want to be what you're around and what you see all the time. So, take for instance, go ahead. What you about to say?
What makes the difference between a good Southern woman and a good East Coast woman and a good Midwest woman?
The way, as a generalization, you always had that select few that's good. But as a general, as in a whole, a lot of Southern women are homie-like.
Can I tell you some of the theories I came up with? The difference between
I'm from the South.
I know you.
I see you West Coast women.
This is my theory. These are my opinions. These are my opinions. So I don't want y'all calling in. We not like that. Whatever.
Yes, y'all are.
I think Southern women.
Okay.
We talking about all good women. We ain't talking about no ratchet. This is all about the good women.
There you go.
Southern good women are more. Hospitable.
Yes.
Okay. East Coast women are more good women are more like loyal. Damn. They're like real loyal. They ride or die chicks.
There it is.
Sort of Southern. Okay.
Midwest women are more well rounded. I like them. They're well rounded women. Like I really, they have it all. They will
you're
go
You're saying that because you're Midwest.
Whatever.
No, LL Cool J said it. I need a really round way girl. It's
Midwest. And I'm sorry to say this, but even the good women, West Coast women, are just trophy pieces. They just look like they're just trophy pieces. They don't really cook that much. I'm not saying that y'all can't, but a taco burrito is just it ain't it, the taco. I mean,
that's true though.
They just more of a trophy piece than me.
I give it to them.
Wait.
But
what do you mean trophy piece?
Like they just look good. They just look pretty.
They just look superficial.
They just pretty. That don't mean they're not good women. Right. Because all we're talking about is good women. We're not talking about the ratchet. Because ratchet is the same from east to west.
Regardless. There you go.
There's levels of ratchetness.
There you go. I'm not going to get on that. But I have to agree with them, though, with the West Coast woman. I mean, you know, you take a woman from the Midwest or East Coast, when they're going out, they're going to flip them heels on. They're going to get sexy with it. Women on the West Coast, flip-flops.
They put on heels here. They're the trophy.
But you know what? I'm going to say it like this. I know to put on heels. I'm originally from here, though.
Well, how many people are really from here anyway?
Yeah, that's true.
This is a melting pot.
That's what I'm saying. But born and raised.
You know what? Since I'm gonna go there, since you know everybody.
You always say it.
Oh yeah, I'm in the south. South.
I'm not gonna knock the West Coast
Midwest women.
Okay.
I'm not gonna knock the West Coast women.
Yeah. I'm not knocking them either.
I'm not gonna knock them. There's some ones that just not trophies though.
There's
some good ones that are getting that kitchen and burn. There's some ride or die ones.
I bet you they parents from the South or something.
What they gotta do with them? We talking about them. We talking about West Coast women. I'm on the West Coast. I'm gonna let you know it. They're tripping. They're in a box. Pandora's box. They're in that box. West Coast women.
He's trying to get points with y'all.
Thank you.
I got him.
He did.
I got him. No, but real talk. I do think Southern women are different than West Coast women. West Coast women, I think, are fake. I really think a lot of West Coast women are fake because a lot of them want to live that Hollywood life and be this. Like, they so, like, a lot of West Coast women, I say down south because I grew up down south, but I'm around a lot. I've been around a lot, and a lot of West Coast women, they're so small. They're so small.
What do you mean?
They're thin, like they look sick.
Well, you got to remember, Florida and California are the capitals of workout.
That's it. No, they're the capitals of obesity and want to be. I mean, no. They're capital of anorexia and want to be like from Hollywood. No, but your ribs are showing. That ain't cute. That's not cute. You put on the two-piece and your ribs showing. Something wrong with you. Go eat. Go to a hometown buffet. Sit at the buffet. Don't go get a chair somewhere else. Sit at the buffet.
You know Doreen gonna talk about that.
She can talk about that. I love the thickness in a woman.
I bet you do.
I love the thickness in a woman.
I bet you do. Because you from where?
The South. We know how to appreciate a woman. Not these thin, look like they need a protein IV.
Well, yeah, but like you said, a good woman is a good woman, regardless of size. If a woman is good, she's good.
But some women are different.
If all things being equal, we're just talking about good women. A Southern good woman.
What was the question? Is there a difference
in the regional of women?
Yeah, there's a region. Yeah, there is, because there's a difference between the regional and men as well too.
I mean, because women say it all the time. I want a good Southern man.
Right.
But
right.
What's the difference? A lot of West Coast men don't like to get married. They'll stay with the woman and live in a woman house for years won't marry her.
But you know what? That's because the woman allows that to happen. That's a different story.
That's a whole different story.
We're different too.
Because
Southern men are different.
Women will do what you allow to do.
A lot of West Coast dudes that I see don't know how to respect a woman. And they always want a gangbang and want to bang on them all the damn time.
We're talking about good dudes and good women. We're not talking about no ratchets.
My fault.
We're just talking about the good men and good women. Today we're not on the ratchets.
But what's good though? And what is considered a good woman is a good man.
Really? A good woman is someone that's about consistency, loyalty.
Someone who ain't ratchet.
Responsibility.
That's all.
I mean, at the end of the day, somebody handles their business. That's my definition of a good woman. She handles her business.
Well, you just quiet. Oh, we got a caller. Call in and let us know what's up. Tell us your name and where you calling from.
Hello? This is Doreen, and I'm calling from Victor.
Can you turn her up?
That's Doreen.
Go ahead.
It's Doreen, and I'm calling from Victor. Can you hear me?
Not yet. One moment. Doreen.
Yes.
We can barely hear you, but go ahead.
It's not hers. We can't hear her here.
Oh.
Okay, woman. Okay, so I'm calling her. What's up?
Okay, go ahead, Doreen.
Okay, I want to chime in. How y'all doing this evening, first of all?
Cool.
All right, so we're going to get Doreen. Doreen, we're going to work this out. Okay, I think we got you.
Go ahead.
Yes, we
can
hear you.
Okay, I want to chime in on the good woman thing.
Uh-oh.
Okay.
Okay, yes, I do. Being from the East Coast, I have a lot to say. But I agree with you guys, and I agree with Tony in the aspect that a good woman is a good woman, be it East Coast or West Coast, just like a good man is a good man. But like you guys brought up, some guys, like DJ was saying, that I bet their moms are from down south or are down south womanness. But I think it all goes back to your upbringing, how you were brought up, how your mother, how you've seen your mother be a woman, and how you become a woman.
Look out now.
Preach!
Right.
And I think that's where it comes from.
Yeah.
You know, regardless of what coast you're from.
Right. But I mean, you know how some women say, "I want a good Southern man." I mean, do you having a good Southern man, if you find a good West Coast man, would that not be? Would you feel like you missing out on something?
They just going by the perception that they've heard other women say. If you get a good Southern man, he's gonna take care of you. If you get a, they can be a Southern man that ain't worth a dime either. I mean, let's
just say that. But I mean, all things being equal, we're just talking about all good people. All things being equal.
But you know, as far as California women have to actually, you know, step up for them for a little bit, people become different up their environment. Once you come to California, you kind of get into the California lifestyle. Like you guys were talking about, the California women don't dress because that's called California casual. They don't feel they have to.
That's it.
You know, they just become victims of their environment. That's all. So somebody tells them
different. I agree.
That's what's up. Well, I'm glad you set us straight about that. So basically, you're saying there is no difference. It's all the same.
Exactly. A good woman is a good woman, and a good man is a good man.
Yeah.
It don't matter if you're from Mars or if you're from Japan. If you're a good man and you got the good background and the good upbringing, you're a good man.
Okay.
And same with a woman. And if you ain't a good man or you're not a good woman, you're not going to be a good woman no matter where you live.
Look out now.
That's what's up. So we need to just kill the fact that people say I want a good Southern anything.
No.
What?
No, we ain't killing that.
yeah, get past that. If those little country boys DJs that always swear that the Southern women, if they were so good, you'd be there with them.
She went there. She okay, done hit the belt.
First of all, make the picture small.
She done hit the belt.
We probably don't want to be in the South, but we still want a Southern woman. So we probably want our cake and eat it too. And I hate that, Frank, that term. You still want to eat it. And I hate it. So yes, that's what we want. We want our cake and eat it too.
Church,
we want to be in the South, but we want a Southern woman.
Thank you.
Church said she'll beat your butt. Saying that thin women look sick and weak.
Oh! Thank you, Doreen. Your picture's up. Everybody, that's Miss Doreen right there.
She's good, girl. Look at you.
All right. Thank you, gentlemen. You guys have a good night.
Give a shout out. What's your blog?
My blog is keeping it real at blogspot.com.
Okay.
Keep it real. That's what I'm talking about, Doreen.
Talk to you later. Thank you, boo.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Good night.
Yep, that was Miss Doreen, everybody. Y'all heard her blog, and we is getting it going up in here. We getting it started already. We got one good call already.
Look at that. DJ making these women mad.
Man, that's what he's doing, talking about
skin.
Y'all heard what Tracy done texted this man and told
him. Don't get you, boy. You better watch your back in the streets.
Oh, man, we are moving. We are moving right along. Tell these people where they can Skype in and call in and everything.
You want to Skype in? You want to call in just like the lovely Mr. Reed just did? Skype address is My DJ's Radio. You want to call in 760-798-9848. Hit us up. Let us know what you're thinking.
Oh,
yes, sir.
So our main topic for this evening, I know you women have been asking this question for a long time. Give me the drum roll.
You focusing on women today?
Hey, that's
it. Man came.
Yeah, but we got to answer some of these questions.
All right, whatever. Go ahead.
Boom. It's chivalry dead?
Oh. Now. Ding, 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 ding.
Is it dead?
I brought some facts with me this evening since my co-host DJ always on facts.
Oh, it is.
Let me see the baby. Let me see you.
It's my fact, baby.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, is chivalry dead? Let's see. Do gentlemen open car doors, chairs? Do they pump your gas? Give you flowers on first dates? Do they pay for dinners? Compliment you? Give you a jacket when you're cold. Do they walk on the outside of the curb and you walk on the inside? These are chivalrous. What's the word?
Chivalrous
things that a man is supposed to do
there
for a woman. Is chivalry dead? Is it dead? Is it dead? Do you do these things?
You talk, Tony.
Do you do these things, Tony?
I do everything.
Since you got all these facts.
Yeah, everything you, got all you just say, I do.
You do do?
I do. I wouldn't call those for women. I show them respect. I open up the doors. If we walk in, I walk on the side of the street. If somebody's leg is taken off, it's going to be mine. I do all of that. You know what I'm saying? When it comes down to even, you know, going out paying, you know, my rule of thumb when it comes down to that is whoever does the asking should do the paying.
I believe in that.
That's it. So if one asks me out, I'm looking for you to put the bill, sweetheart. Not saying that I can't.
Because you asked me for my time.
Right. Because you don't know if I got money on me or not.
Exactly.
And so all of those things I do, but I do, to answer the question, I say yes, chivalry is dead. And it's not because men aren't doing it, it's because women have allowed it to die.
Uh-oh, he's perfect. Coming with the facts. Watch out. Facts. You ain't gonna talk about his facts this week, buddy. He done got on.
In simply states, women, you might not like me. This is a little topic saying for saying this, but if chivalry is dead, you are the ones who killed it.
Okay.
Because of wanting to be independent. Because of the equality thing. Mm-hmm. And all of them want to be equal. So men feel like, hey, you want to be equal? Open the damn door yourself. You want to be equal? Pull that shirt out yourself. You want to be equal? So, and that's what the facts are saying, right?
It looks like these. You got some facts over here, too. I'm just saying. Y'all can't see what I see, but it look like DJ. DJ got some facts over here.
So I would say the chivalry itself is not dead, but in an essence, it has been. It is dead because, like I said, women have killed it because of those different things. You know, because of the fact that they want to be equal. They want to be, you know, treat me like this. And I don't need no man. You know, women always say, I don't need no man. I can do it myself. I can pay my own bill. So men feel like, well, hey, that's how you feel. Why should I? You know, go the extra mile for you then. You
want
to be independent?
Yeah, I think he's talking to you. What you got to say about that?
DJ, we want you to chime in, bro. I mean,
I don't
want anything
to
bitch.
I think he does.
Well, I'm going to go ahead and say, I don't think it's just the women that, I don't think it's just the women that kill chivalry. I don't think it's just women as a whole. It's also us men that don't want to do it. And we be damned when we do it. Because it's a private thing to some of us. Because, you know, if we do certain things, it's what our homeboy is going to think of us. Oh, man, you doing what? You got less of a backbone. And then it also goes about society. Society has a lot to do with chivalry, too. Because chivalry just don't go into romantic stages. It don't go just because I want to date this girl. Chivalry also goes if you see an old lady coming from the store, we used to grab the groceries. So we don't do that anymore.
Right.
And then technology has something to do with it, too. Right. When did I tell you wrote a letter and sprayed perfume on it to a girl?
Me?
Yesterday. Let me guess. Yesterday, Tony.
Yesterday.
Last month, huh?
Within the last month, I have done that.
Oh, good. Whatever. He's lying.
Negro, no, I'm lying. Do you live with me? Huh?
Cameras, you know, like, back in the day, we used to write a letter and put your favorite cologne and mail it to the lady and then, you know, that felt good. Now, we just quick to send a quick text. How many of y'all actually talk to? Chivalry don't go, like I said, romantic, say you go to friendship well, too, even at the job. How many of us have actually sat and at the same cubicle or worker space as your coworker, instead of emailing them, hey, how you doing today? They right next door. You get your tail up and go talk to them. How many of us do that?
You don't want to get fired, though.
It ain't about getting fired, you know what I'm saying? It works both ways, but chivalry has died because of the human, because the world has evolved and all of us are self-centered. We don't care about you.
Yeah. But who's saying the question is, do women feel that chivalry is dead?
No, is it dead?
No matter if it's men or women.
I feel as if I'm going to be the devil's advocate right here, I guess. I think, honestly, it's failed because women have failed even knowing what chivalry is.
Thank you.
What is chivalry, LJ? Since the woman has failed at it, you a man, you should know what chivalry is. What chivalry is then?
I don't need this. I've been single for quite some time. I don't need that.
I know what it chivalry is.
To be honest with you, chivalry nowadays is what women look as a form of weakness.
That's true.
For them?
That's true.
Period. Because if you do these things and And if you do these things and the woman likes you, but not, she's on the borderline, she sees that as being a cornball because you did these things. Like, I could take a woman out on a date and open up a door and get to her house at a decent hour and knock on her door and go up, but then that'll be doing too much.
Yeah,
that's doing too much.
That's true.
So you know, that's it, it looks, it seems as a form of weakness to women nowadays, but hold on, I know what most and every woman is going to say, that's the ratchet women you deal with. No, it's you too.
Thank you.
It's you too.
It's actually Shiver is actually double standards for Keegar.
It is, but I mean, we have double standards that women have to deal with all the time too. So
that's true.
I'll deal with the double standards, mm-hmm. but I feel that it's looked upon now as a form of weakness because instead of me opening the door, if I with my alarm, that's cute. If I call you from my cell phone instead of going up to your door and ringing the doorbell, if I call you from my cell phone and tell you I'm here, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? Because basically you don't want me to even come to your house almost sometimes. You know what I'm saying? So and paying for stuff?
Yeah, okay. Good sweet Jesus right there. Okay. That's the thing right there. Because some women don't understand the equality thing. But I've been down that road where you call me up. I'm sitting on my couch relaxing.
I think some of the real chivalry things that you're supposed to do, I don't even think women even know you're supposed to. I don't think women even know that a man was supposed to walk on the outside when they're walking down the street. I don't even think they knew that.
And a lot of it has to deal with, when you say that, a lot of it too has to deal with a lot of male figure. To show them,
right,
or someone to tell them, hey, this is how you're supposed to be treated as a woman, right. They don't know,
which so, is what so, I do right. for my daughter.
That's what I do with mine. They get into that habit of the boy roll up, bump, 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 nigga running out the door. I told my daughter, if a Negro ever, ever, ever in his life roll up and blow the horn, you run out that door, I'm gonna beat your behind, then I'm gonna go out there, I'm gonna beat his behind. He gonna get his butt out the car, he gonna walk to the door, he gonna ring it, he gonna introduce himself. What a man's supposed to do.
Right.
At the end of the night, he can walk you to that door.
Get out the way.
That's it.
Get out the way.
I mean, how many men do you know, what, we drop a lady off? Just pull off. Don't even see if she gets to the house.
Walk
into
the door, none of that.
Just pull off. All right, good night.
How many women actually get in the car with a man these days? I'll meet you there.
Yeah.
But you hit it right on the button.
Do women really want chivalry? First of all, do they really want it?
Do they?
That's the good question. Women, do you really want it?
We better yet.
Yeah, call in, let us know, do you really even want it?
The question I'm
DJ here right on the money. I'll meet you there.
The question I want you is, do you want it? And better yet, do you deserve it?
They don't value it. This
time. I don't look out now.
They don't value
it. Because, you know, but on that note, I agree with you there. If you want to be,
they don't want it until they fall in love with you.
Or the main one is right. they don't want that until they see one of their homegirls getting treated as such.
Ooh.
And they see it
They
see it outside on the outside. Look, he opened his door. He opened her door, pulled out her chair. You know, wiped her silverware off.
Ooh.
Did all this.
You know that?
But no.
I was like, brother, you wiped a silverware.
But they don't know. See, why you can't be like Jason? Jason always doing this, but what they don't know, Jason is whooping her butt off. Jason going upside her head all the time. But when he get out in public,
I hate that. You know what I hate? Why don't we go for walks on the beach at night? Because the last time we went down you went down there and you told me you was cold all night. And I gave you a jacket and you ain't even want to be down there. That's so it. We ain't going down there no more.
That's it. And another thing too, what kills chivalry is the fact that some women take, or you trying to be chivalrous as meaning that you trying to hit on them and you're not.
True.
I caught him something like that. Female was cold. I just loaned her my jacket.
You want to get out of there, but go ahead.
No. I'm not getting it. No. I'm just trying to be a gentleman. That's how I was raised. I'm from the Midwest. Mm-hmm. You know, we Midwest.
I don't know in the South.
Well, I know because y'all.
Well, let me tell you. Y'all know. Let me tell you.
Great Kool-Aid chicken is on for the summer.
I want to give a shout out to my uncle and all the men that I watched coming up because of this right here. The men that I watched coming up, whether they were players or not, they still had gentleman-like qualities, and even the women right back then required those qualities. They might have been players or whatever, but they still did certain things that made them gentlemen. Nowadays, if you flashing money and you just you who you are, a woman is just they cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs over, and you ain't got to do nothing.
Thank you.
You ain't got to do nothing.
And you got to get on the money. That's why, to a certain extent, chivalry has died. And it's because, like we said, women have killed it. Because a man is only going to treat you.
You know what? We got a woman. Flynn, Phelan, Fallon.
You high five, Green Light Radio in the house. Where you at, girl?
Green Light Radio in the house.
Are we just basically saying chivalry as far as a relationship? Or are we just saying chivalry as a whole? Because when you sneeze, I'm going to say, bless you, but nobody say nothing.
I understand. I understand that. You're talking about as a relationship.
But what pissed me off, all the way
you
to the top.
You seem to be mad, too.
In the top of to the
I can see you steam.
All the way to the that pink, top of my
that pink head turn red
is when you get up in the freaking morning. When you get up in the morning and you walk past people and you tell them good morning
and they don't say nothing
and them ass
well boy hot tonight
and them people don't tell you good morning back. It gets under my skin. But I'm that guy that tell you good morning 15 times till you tell me good morning back.
Well,
I hate that. My grandma always told me that. If I woke up in the morning and didn't tell somebody, she'd tell you, did I sleep with you last night?
Ooh.
And that's what you do.
Sometimes you better tell somebody good morning. But these people around here get up on an elevator or we get to work in the morning, tell your coworkers good morning. It's a good morning. Jesus got your butt up this morning. And I hate when
he
I text
mad.
You.
DJ is mad.
Matter of fact, let me tell you about chivalry right quick with the good morning part.
When I tell you
good morning, don't tell me morning. You better put a good in front of that. It's a good morning. It ain't just a morning.
You know what? DJs, you know what? I seen DJ mad. The only other time I seen DJ this mad is when people type in God with only the G capitalized and not the O-D.
The capital G
capitalized and not the OD, just G.
It means different. It's a different meaning.
But so he liked that.
What's a different meaning?
What lowercase the capital G. We're not gonna go biblical right now, but lowercase.
No,
G.
The capital G.
No,
is
he
correct.
Said
the capital
everything.
G.
Yeah.
No, small O.
I just do
small
B.
Okay.
G. I say
and
capital
G. You say
lowercase
D, that H should be capitalized too.
But anyway,
okay. But I figured it.
But right. That was something off subject.
But
yeah,
okay. But
I like chivalry. To be honest with you, and I'm gonna be truthful. I'm gonna go on.
It should separate you from other men.
But you know what? I'm gonna go on after the TV and tell you right now. I'm gonna go and tell you right now. I didn't know what chivalry was
until it took a woman
to show me what a man's supposed to do in certain things.
Open the door. Ding 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 ding.
It took a woman to show me that because. I didn't have a man to tell me that. I didn't have a man that would tell me you supposed to open the door for that woman.
I thought it was player. You supposed to open the door for the woman.
You supposed to
get around the money.
Walk on the side of the street. I didn't have that. It took me to get in a relationship with a woman on the West Coast that was like
I grew up with.
You need to, you know, open the door, pull out my chair.
Ooh.
Like I was like, no, you pull out your own.
Ooh.
But then it opened up my eyes.
Okay. Oh, we got a call. We got a caller coming in. Caller.
Yes.
Come on, caller.
Yeah.
Yes, this is Erica.
Hey, Erica, how you doing? Where are you calling from? Oh, okay. What's your question?
Hey, Erica, can you turn down your radio?
Yeah. Turn it down. Please, there we go.
Okay, I'm good.
All right. Okay, Erica, so what's your question?
My question is, what do actually, one thing I do agree with you guys that the radio has kind of died out.
Uh-huh.
And the second, my question is, what if the girl is a cowboy and doesn't understand chivalry?
Oh, that's
a good question.
What if she's what if the girl is tomboyish and she doesn't understand chivalry? So do that mean chivalry is required for the tomboy or not?
I think more like it's like,
that's a good question.
You know, when your girl, you know, with guys, it's just kind of hard to, when the guy does like you and he does that, you're like,
Hey, Erica.
You feel weird.
Right.
Erica, turn your radio off. Cause we get the feedback, so turn your radio off.
Okay.
Oh, so basically you're saying if the girl is tomboyish and she has a guy
that's
doing chivalry type stuff, you're feeling funny because that's not something that you ever experienced before.
Right.
Yeah.
So maybe the tomboy boy should pull out his chair and pay his bill.
You know what? That is a really good question. But you're still a woman that wants to date a man, regardless.
Yeah,
not you.
I'm still
somewhere in my 30s, but in my 20s,
I had a hard time
and
getting comfortable with the man. It's
really annoying me,
just, you know, just being comfortable.
So you're in your 30s?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Well, I'm not Dr. Phil, so that's a tough one. Hey, but at the beginning of the night, if you like a guy and he does have gentlemanlike qualities and chivalry, what I am saying to you is don't knock him for doing those things. That's what I am going to say, because those things should be respected as such. Whether or not you feel funny about it or not, you should still respect those things, because that's what a man should do for a woman regardless. So even if you two have a child together or something, you still want that your daughter to grow up understanding that this is what a man should do.
And I agree with you with everything, and that's what I started doing when I did start dating. Well, after long I'm not dating, but yeah, I just took baby steps.
That's right. Okay, Erica, well, thank you for calling. We really do appreciate you. You can check us out here every Wednesday night at 9 o'clock.
Appreciate that.
Much love. Funny, man. Keep it for real, man.
Okay, thank you. Take it easy.
Bye-bye.
Wow, did she hit us with a question that kind of almost threw me a curveball right there?
But at the end of the day, you hit it right on the money.
Yeah.
If you're a woman, regardless of whether you got tomboyish qualities or not, you're still a woman, and as such, you should still be treated with the same respect as a extra feminine woman at the end of the day. Mm-hmm. Chivalry is chivalry. But back to what DJ pointed out, you said it took a woman to show you that. That's what I'm saying. A man is only going to treat you the way you allow you know him to treat you.
Yeah, but us men today, we should teach our little ones, our little men, how to do and what not to do.
We got another phone call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
My name is
Tanika.
You're calling from
Houston. Can you turn your radio off?
Oh, okay. We getting feedback in here.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay, how you doing?
I'm all right. And yourself?
Who is this?
Good. I just kind of have a statement. I do agree with kind of all of y'all, but I kind of want to lean a little bit more towards women. I think that it's about yourself and what you hold, you know, yourself as far as value. Us as women, not us, but women nowadays are not holding themselves as value to deserve chivalry, if you ask me.
Right.
I mean, if we tell you guys basically what we want, you're not mind readers, you know, y'all gonna give it to us pretty much. You're willing to do that. But other than that, I don't think that women are holding themselves, you know, their standards are just not high enough to actually feel like they deserve it
or want it or even know what it is, like you guys said earlier. But I do agree with all y'all pretty much.
Oh, okay. So what do you think? What do you think we should do as a society to maybe change some of those things?
As a society, I mean, it's kind of like a man versus. It's kind of like a man versus woman thing. I mean, I hate to be biased on that note, but when you speak of chivalry, it is something that you would think that a man gives a woman, and that's kind of why I go back to saying this is the comment that I'm making as far as I think women should respect themselves more, you know? I mean, I feel like nowadays women are very, very easy now. It's easy for guys to say, you know what, whatever, you don't want to accept this, I'm going to move on to the next. But as far as what should be done, I'm in the blue. I don't know myself.
Do you have any kids?
I do. I have a daughter. She's 5 years old.
And do you teach your daughter as far as the things that should be expected? Period. Because the reason why I'm saying this is because my daughter's 15, and. Mm-hmm. I've always done the same things with her. So, but when she got to a certain age, what I then began to do was I explained to her, I don't do this just because I'm your daddy. I'm doing this to show you that if a man don't at least do these things, then he shouldn't be qualified to do anything beyond this.
That's it.
Absolutely. And I agree with you. And the reason why I do agree with you is because I'm a daddy's girl. I mean, I could probably call my dad right now and just talk to him about anything. So I do agree with you as well. So if you ask them the question as far as society, as far as dads now, I feel that dads now are being a way more active with their kids,
right,
whether it's a boy or a girl. I feel like, you know, dads between the ages of 30 and above probably are a lot more active. I'm married. My husband he has a little girl that's 5 years old, and I feel like he's extremely active with our daughter as far as, you know, letting her know what's right and what's wrong. But me as a mom and being a dad's girl also know, all right, I'm trying to teach her that, hey, you don't open the door for a man or your friend or a little boy that's a friend of yours, you know, and don't take the lead as far as when you're playing with him. Don't take the lead and say, hey, do this, do this, do that.
That's
just kind of chill and play with him, you know?
Right. Well, that's what's up. What was it? We didn't catch your name at the beginning. What was your name again?
It's Tranika. What's up, Darnell?
What's up? Tranika. What's up, girl?
It's Tranika.
Oh, we done got this man real. We done got this man real down here.
Did I get what? I'm sorry. Say that again.
I said you put my government name on there. Just say DJ, cuz.
Oh, I didn't know, baby. I just was, you know, I was saying what's up to you. My bad.
That's my cousin. That's my cousin, Lushy.
We really do appreciate you calling.
Yes, sir. Love you, cuz.
No problem. You guys continue to keep it real.
All right, now.
What's down with it, cuz?
Well.
Oh, my God. Bye.
Well, look at here. We done got some really interesting calls and people really participating in today's in today's
government
topics. Man, wow, it is really getting deep in here. So, at the end of the day, the chivalry in the beginning of the night, chivalry falls on the woman.
It does. At the end of the day,
it falls like on the woman, because men is only
how you want to be treated.
Only going. Well, look at here. Hello,
look out now. Like from Green Bay Radio. Oh, busting all up in here. So come on, give us your thought.
On chivalry?
Yes.
I think it's still alive. I've seen it in some men today. I think more men are trying with the chivalry. In the 2013, 2012, 2011, take it back to 2010 even. Before then, I think it was an image that men had to maintain because women were stepping over men. We have a new independence.
Mm-hmm. Destiny Sharon did that.
Destiny Sharon?
Sure.
Destiny Sharon?
Sure.
Yeah. Anyway, so I think women started to step on men with their independence, and so men stopped being chivalrous. But I think women are now starting to accept the man and woman role, mm-hmm. and are starting to accept chivalry. I don't think it's dead. I think,
but by it being missing, by it being gone for so long, do you think the younger generation even understand or know what it is?
No, and there's not a lot of men to teach them
right now. I mean, it's not a lot of people to teach the younger generation.
Women too, though.
Right.
Women too can teach. You got to, like, a mother should teach her daughter.
But if she don't even know what it is, how's she gonna teach her?
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, because what if that woman? What if her father wasn't in the picture and he didn't teach her how a man was supposed
to be? But to be honest with you, men naturally kind of know what it is because it's a natural feeling that comes over us, especially when we have daughters. It's something that
raising our kids,
right? Yeah. But even when we're dating, sometimes there's a feeling that you get like, I think I'm supposed to do this. It's natural.
I think it's different when you raise your little girl and advice doing it for her. I think it's kind of different.
But it's the same thing.
Like my boy just said, he bought his wife, Jesse in New Orleans, he bought his wife some roses just out of nowhere. Mm-hmm. And then he said his daughter came home and said, "Dad, that was nice of you to buy mommy some roses." Mm-hmm. He said, "That's what men are supposed to do if they're in a relationship with you."
See, right. but what if chivalry is a different definition from, what if it differs from you and you and you? What if chivalry to him is offering his coat? What if chivalry to you is just being home every single night? What if that's considered chivalry?
Gentlemen, we have a phone call. Gentlemen, we have a phone call.
We have a phone call. Phone caller, what's your name and where are you calling from?
Oh, I'm Victoria. I'm calling from Memphis, but I'm from Memphis.
Okay, Menifee, but from by way of Memphis. Right. What's your question?
You know what? I don't have one. I wanted to say, hey, how y'all doing?
Oh, well, thank you, Toya. We doing all right. How long you been listening to our show? This your first time?
This is my second time. My husband called last week. I've been listening to about 20 seconds. Y'all sound good.
Look good too.
What do you think about chivalry? You think about chivalry? Is it dead? Do your husband still do it?
I guess it depends on the man. Some it is, and it ain't. It depends. My husband, no. That's a no. No go. He has that potential. So maybe in the near future we can, get it cracking.
That's Toya. Ladies and gentlemen, the caller is Toya. That's the one I was telling you about the rap. She's the one who's...
I'm going to ask him after this because I feel like maybe if some more men start doing it, then they'll see it. Other men will see it and try it out for the 2013 because it's pretty much gone.
Yeah, it is gone. Mm. It's definitely gone. Mm.
It would be nice to still, get your chair pulled out. And not to do a trick and make you fall, it would be nice.
Well, that's what's up. Well, whoever your husband is, we're gonna let him know. Hey, you need to pull out Toya chair because she just got her nails done.
Jesus, tell him, and he's listening. So make sure y'all tell him. Otherwise, he's gonna get the game.
I'm gonna tell him so he can add another 10-15 years onto that marriage.
But chisel,
all right. All
right,
then, little
mama. Well, I'm letting my friends know so they'll be tuning in to y'all radio station. I wish y'all luck in everything that y'all do. Be easy, stay funny, and keep it real.
All right. Thank you so much.
Much love.
Well, bye, we have come to the end of our show, the things to do for this week. My boy, AG. He got 945 going on. He got this thing called Good Music Saturdays. You can stop by there. But besides that, I really don't. No one is giving me anything.
Come to the Stab Club. I've been there this Friday night putting it down on the ones and twos. So if you want to come through, come on through. Free admission.
LJ.
Good catfish, good drinks.
Before you go, though, I know we were talking about chivalry for men and stuff. What about what the women need to do?
We hit that already.
Well, I wasn't here, so.
We gotta look at the show again. We gotta try to cut him off. But I agree with you, though, bro. Women need to step their game up, too.
Yeah. Well, for the most part, women need to appreciate the ship.
Thank you.
They need to appreciate it and not look at it as, oh, he's a cornball.
Thank you.
Or or oh, he's weak. I want a man with edge. That's a thug. Okay, you gonna get your butt beat. So yeah, so much for that. You know what I'm talking about? I just like I said, I've been single for quite some time, and I know like women that the things that they appreciate. It's not so much the chivalry. It's the dude with the edge. Mm. The dude that look like they're going to beat him. But not quite. Yeah.
The only thing you think they should do is appreciate?
No.
Appreciate.
No. There's things that they should do, too.
Well, I mean, that's like a whole nother show.
Like what?
They
at the end of the day, you know, they want the man to pull out the chair. They want the man to, you know, do all that. Get a man a back rub. Cook the man a meal. You know, encourage the man. If the man is feeling down, if he off his game, be the supporter.
We're talking about
long term, bro.
But I'm saying the first.
I'm a back rub on the first day.
I'm just talking about. If you're talking about first dates, then I'm just saying appreciate that. Understand that. That's not that. I just want my gentleman like qualities to be taken for. Exactly that, and not weakness, and give me that phone call back. Like, this dude was a really nice dude. I'm going to call him back.
Right.
Period.
That's it.
Okay.
I just need to know that eventually I'm gonna get to where I need to get to. You know what I mean?
I got a question for y'all. Can a woman order for you?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Yes.
Or like, as far
not
as, like,
if she don't know me.
You go out to eat. Can she? And you guys are sitting there, and you like, you know what? I think I'm gonna have a lobster. And the lady, the waitress comes over, and she orders for your date. Orders for both of you.
Would she know I wanted the lobster?
Yeah,
that's perfectly fine with me.
Well, I mean, yeah. Well, I had a lady order for me when I went someplace totally new. I went to sushi. I was like, you know, I'm open to try anything. You make the order, and she ordered the sushi for me. I was totally fine with that.
But don't make me eat what I don't want to eat.
Yeah.
That's a different one.
No, you should try this. Now, you know what I hate? I hate when I order some food and you order some food and you start eating all my shit. Like, look, check this out. Check this out. I know how much my food costs. And I know how much I got. And I know I look skinny, but I eat a lot. I had accounted for every chicken on my plate. I had accounted for every bean on my plate. Everything that was on my plate. Don't be sticking your fork in my food. Don't do that. That ain't chivalry. That's just greedy.
My cousin said the way to stop that is eat like you're in prison.
Obviously, I ain't never been to prison. You like that?
That's what's up. That's what's up. We
Green Light Radio doing it, y'all. They on one tonight.
We are on our way out.
Yes, sir.
And while we on our way out, DJ is going to hit us with some DJology, as he call it.
DJology, the study of DJ.
Oh, sweet Jesus.
I got two. One is every day you should expect to be great. You should never look to yesterday as being your best day. Tomorrow should always be greater. You should begin there and build and start your legacy. Yes, I wrote that myself. Yeah, I wrote that myself. And the mind twister for this one is if you want to succeed, double your failure rate.
That's true.
Marinate on that one for a while.
Yeah, I'm puzzled off of that one. I will comment on that one next week. I'm comment on that one next week.
I caught you, baby.
And that is the end of our show, The Man Cave, where men are welcome. Women enter at your own risk.
Stay tuned for Green Light Radio, y'all. They finna put it down. Green Light, coming up next.
Deuces.
See y'all next week.
That's a good show right there. Mm-hmm. That was right on the money. Them women was calling in on that one, boy.